Hello, everyone. My name is Sarah Krasin, Senior Vice President with CCS Fundraising's Boston office. The core business of our firm is campaign planning and management, and we've had the distinct privilege of partnering with many Mass Cultural Council grantees over the years. Thank you for inviting me to share a perspective on the role campaign feasibility studies play in a time of stress or great uncertainty. Especially over the past 15 months, my colleagues at CCS and I have been asked over and over again if we think fundraising as we knew it has been changed forever. Particularly for our friends and clients in the arts and culture space, the past year has been extraordinarily challenging, and the idea of pursuing bold plans and big campaigns seems counterintuitive. But I'm here to offer the perspective that it's not counterintuitive at all. And in fact, that undertaking a feasibility study during a time of stress or uncertainty could actually be one of the most powerful things your organization can do. When COVID first hit, CCS reflected back on our experience working with nonprofits during 2008 and 2009 in the midst of the Great Recession. From our perspective, the key takeaway from that time, with the benefit of hindsight, was this: those organizations that kept going, kept engaging with their donors, and kept activity moving were ultimately rewarded. These successful organizations, and we did work with many, many nonprofits who successfully completed campaigns during or immediately after the recession, recognized that they couldn't control the broader economy, but doubled down on what they could control. Those who stopped, paused, delayed, especially around campaign efforts, they faced significant challenge on the other side of that crisis, as many of their loyal donors, having not been engaged by the organizations they were supporting, had found other interests. So even when the economic climate is strong, we would never recommend that as a primary reason to test or proceed with a campaign. It helps, certainly, but trying to time the market with a feasibility study to wait for a more certain time, a better stock market, certainty around COVID reemergence and so forth, it can be paralyzing. Regardless of when you conduct a campaign, there's always going to be competition for the philanthropic dollar. And in working with many cultural institutions over the past year, we focused on helping them put their best foot forward, running their own race, and going to your supporters to ask if they will help. And regardless of what kind of stress that we're ultimately under, because let's be honest, we live in a time of perpetual stress, it seems, there's a natural need for more communication at those moments rather than less. No donor, particularly at the highest and most engaged levels, wants to watch their beloved cultural institutions go through a major crisis, delay an important project, or in the worst case, close, and be left asking, is there something else that I could have done? So my call to action to all of you is this: if you have a campaign worth pursuing, don't just view the feasibility study as a decision-making tool. Instead, take a broader lens. A study, when done well, can at a very peer level help us get back to the basics of donor engagement and retention, where we invite donors to be our real partners in advancing our mission. Thanks again to NMBL Strategies for the opportunity for CCS to share this perspective.